Are you someone who have just stepped into the real dental world, or who has just started with a clinic, or might be thinking of one? Then this video is for you. Hey friends, I'm Dr. Hilary and welcome to DentoWoman. This channel is all about dentistry and dentists. So today we have a guest on our channel, Dr. Hetal Anadkat. She's been practicing as dental surgeon since past 15 years. I'm very grateful for having a mentor like her. When I was in my second, third year of MDS, I used to visit her clinic and I used to observe the way she deals with patients, the way she deals with her MRs and her staff. Just by observing her, I have learned a lot. And so we decided to do this video for all those budding dentists. I'm sure ma'am's advice would help you all in your clinical career. So any further ado, let's get started.
Hey, thank you for the introduction. And it's good to be on your channel. So today I'm going to talk to the budding dentist about ergonomics. Ergonomics is the proper positioning while doing patients, which is often neglected by young dentists who initially start and they are not bothered until they develop a few musculoskeletal symptoms. So it's better to position yourself and patients properly while practicing, which is very, very important. Choosing the best product is very, very crucial. That will help you and your patients and it will satisfy everybody. So never go for lucrative offers which MR and everybody offers. You should know what products to be used. Don't be greedy. Don't go for cheaper products. Use standard products which are used all over the world, right? Don't go for alginate impressions for final impressions. Always take a putty impression, right? And choose the better putty of putty material. Right, choosing a better putty is very important. It will help you in final fitting. Otherwise, you will end up making lot of corrections in the final fitting, and you will be spending a lot of time in it. And we don't want that. Time is very important. So always go for a better material. Don't use cheap or Chinese material. Always go for standard materials. Now, regarding the charges, which you have to decide initially. You have to decide your own charges without looking at the charges of any other dentist. You have to act according to the charges which are decided by IDA. And you decide your own charges. Don't let the patients bargain, because bargaining is very bad, and once it happens, it becomes a habit with the patients. Don't charge less. Charging appropriately is very, very important. If you are charging less, then you will compromise on the material. That will finally affect your treatment outcome. That is very, very important. Satisfying the patient is the only key factor which can take you ahead. So don't compromise on your charges. Charge what is appropriate. It is very important to stay updated with the technologies and materials which are coming every day. So you should be watching the updates every day. You should be attending the seminars, symposium, and the annual meetings which are held by IDA every month. Develop healthy communications with the seniors and always be free to talk whenever you are in problem. Never ill speak about any of the dentists, right? That is very important. Once you do that, everybody is going to do that. You should be very sympathetic towards your fellow dentists. Even if they make mistakes, never point it out in front of patients. That is a very bad habit. Mental health and self-care are very important. Save yourself from toxic patients. Give the patients the treatment which they want, not what you want. Explain them all the possible treatment options and let them decide what treatment they want to get it done. They would be satisfied only if the treatment which they want you are giving, not on the treatment which you are forcing on them. So always consider them and what treatment they want. Do that only. don't do extra things also. In your daily practice, you'll come across lot many toxic patients. Toxic patients are those which are never satisfied by any dentist. They'll always ill speak about whatever treatment they have got earlier done and about the usual doctor's general practice. So they'll talk rubbish about them. So try to avoid them, get rid of them, never treat them, they'll never be satisfied and they'll spoil your name. So better to get rid of them. You should filter your patients and don't take such patients. All the best to all the budding dentists. Thanks for watching me. I hope this will help you out and stick to this channel for more amazing videos on dentistry.
All the best to you all for your journey ahead. And don't forget to hit the like button. It will help YouTube to show my video to all those budding dentists. Okay? And don't forget to subscribe. See you soon.